Thank you all for being here today. This is about the state tax credits. They were legislatively passed in 2012, and you can see how much was awarded that year. The next year, the cap of $1.5 million was met in tax credits from the state of Iowa that were given away. The same thing in 2014. And then so far this year, $1.1 million has been awarded, and as of the end of April, $1.8 million was waiting to be awarded. So it's probably going to meet that cap of $4.5 million again this year.
It's actually going to be $5 million.
$5 million, thank you.
The House just passed it last night.
Thank you. The House passed last night that the cap will be $5 million. Iowa is definitely a leader in this. That's great. State eligibility guidelines are on this slide, and you can see those. The state tax credit is 60% of the federal, and I'll get into that a little bit more in another slide, and that's for homeowners or business owners. For the state credit, and I believe an earlier speaker mentioned this, there is a maximum of $5,000 for a homeowner and $20,000 for a business owner for the commercial credits. That's a picture of my house. We've had solar on our house since 2007, and it works just great. We love it. It makes about, provides us with about 80% of our electricity usage. Again, more about the state tax credit. The awards are first come, first served basis, and now that $4.5 million should have been increased to $5 million cap. An application cannot be made for individuals until the system is completed, and for businesses until it has been certified that it is in service. So the businesses need to include a completion sheet or another option from a local utility company that verifies that it has been placed into service. Those are solar evacuated hot water tubes. And again, that system is on our house. It works great. And please take advantage of looking at what Dalton Plumbing has to offer in the way of solar thermal, solar hot water systems. So here's a review of the state tax credit. You need to complete an application, have a copy of the invoice. This information is from the State Department of Revenue website, and I'll have a website address for you on another slide so that you can take that down to get more information. So those are the things that need to happen to get the state tax credit. And again, it's a credit. It's not that you get money back. You get a credit on your taxes from the state or from the federal government. Okay, the federal solar tax credit is for solar hot water or solar PV, solar electric. It's a 30% rebate amount of the system cost if it was placed into service before December 31st, 2012. And I heard Mike Barnes say in his presentation that in 2017, the percentage of the tax credit will be reduced to 10%. And then it will phase out the end of 2017, at least the way it is set up currently. It needs to be on a dwelling that is owned by the taxpayer. There's a stipulation about the solar hot water usage, and this does not apply for swimming pools or hot tubs, just so that you know that up front. The federal also has a bonus depreciation for businesses that is something on top of the credits for businesses. This picture comes from Kelowna, Iowa. It's a solar array on their high school. And at the bottom is the federal website where this information comes from. I've got that on the following slide as well. This is how it would work then for the federal and solar state tax credits working together. The federal is 30% of the system, and then the state is 60% of that federal credit. Another way of looking at it is that the state credit is equivalent to about 18% of the system cost. So combining those two tax credits would equal about 48% of the system cost. And that information comes from the Iowa Environmental Council that has worked very closely with getting these state credits passed. So the example I was provided is the system cost of $10,000. The combined credits would amount to about $4,800. So it's really, really a good deal, as you can see, if you put something on your own home. And that photo is of the World Food Prize building in Des Moines. It's a LEED Platinum building, and that's a 25 kW array on that building. All right, here are places where you can get a lot more information if you would like to have it. The Department of Revenue website, U.S. Department of Energy, Iowa Environmental Council, and then in the state of Iowa, we have a solar training association that is made up of installers and supporters of solar, and that is their website. And I can come back to this one. I have just a couple other pictures that I can show you of some Iowa solar arrays. This is Swiss Colony Warehouse. It's a 150 kW array. These are more business operations. This is a turkey farm in Washington County, and it provides 60% of their needs for their on-site operation. And that is an access energy array, and it reduces, they primarily use it to reduce their electrical needs during the summer peak load hours. I'm going to go back to the to this in case you want to copy any of this information down. I will also tell you that the Iowa Environmental Council they provided some handouts for us today, and those are on the table as you enter the CEEE and then just outside the auditorium that gives more information about the state tax credits. You're welcome to take one of those. Again, I want to let you know that we'll be having a webinar at some point before the end of July with a Department of Revenue speaker about state tax credits. And I will take questions and try to answer them. Yes?
When it comes to farms and separate buildings, is there any restrictions on credits?
That would be a commercial, I believe that would be probably a commercial operation, so whatever the commercial restrictions would be, I mean, up to $20,000 for a commercial operation.
It's not a commercial restriction, it's just a cap on the amount of credit that you can get for an individual commercial electric meter.
But say a new pole building would qualify.
Yeah, if you own two buildings that have two electric meters, you can get two tax credits.
What if I don't have any meters? I don't live there.
Do you own it?
I guess I didn't understand that.
Do you own it, but you don't live there?
I own the property, but there is not a residence there. I should have clarified that.
I think that would be commercial. I would contact the Iowa Department of Revenue. Okay. Other questions? Yes?
So you said about 80% of your house. So how many panels is that?
We have a 5 kW system. That's 30 panels. Yeah, 30 panels.
So is that about $10,000 or is that a...
Well, we put it up in 2007 when the prices were a whole lot higher, a whole lot higher. I don't know what that would cost today. Barry's an installer. Are there other installers that might have an idea what that kind of a system might cost today? Want to give an estimate, Barry?
For that roof, a 5-kilowatt system would probably be between $15,000 and $18,000.
Did you $15,000 to $18,000? Oh, no. Clear your ears, 15 to 18. Yes.
And then you would reduce that by that 48%.
Right, right. Then there would be the federal and state reductions on top of that.
But I thought you said 2012 it was
going to
go down.
I think she misspoke. It's by December 31st, 2016.
Yeah. Okay, great.
Excuse me, after 2016, the federal percentage will decrease.
Now for, I believe for residential customers, the ITC goes away. The 10% is for commercial.
For commercial, okay.
So the commercial, people who purchase commercial panels will continue to get a rebate on the ones they already purchased? Subsequent years, or this would be for new?
Just through 2017.
So you'll be getting it, how many years total was that? And you'll be getting it.
You just get it. It's a one-time. It's just a one-time tax credit. Okay. Just a one-time tax credit.
Okay. So residential owners need to do it now. Commercial owners
have a little bit longer time, at least the way the legislation is now. Yes. Yes.
And just to be clear, the tax credit does not roll over the next year. Is that correct?
I think for the state there is some opportunity to do that. I believe I've read that.
I think the federal does too. The reason that Mike Barnes said it's good to take it in the first year is because then you get your money now.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I think you can roll it over.
That's an important piece.
Yes, it really is because you're
depending on your personal situation. Yeah,
but you're not sure.
No, I'm not.
Other questions that we might be able to answer. Okay, Pat wants to show you. Do you want this microphone?
No, as long as I'm standing here, it'll pick up. I thought I would show you one more picture of PV in Iowa. This is the photovoltaic system on my house, and we've had some questions about what happens when it snows. There we see John up there shoveling off snow. And, you know, you don't have to have a perfect location. Let me show you what happens on my house. In the wintertime, whether it's because I do have some shading on both the east and the west, or it's because I have trees on the west that affect the wind, the snowfall is not always uniform on there, the melt-off is not always uniform, but it's still making a lot of energy, a whole lot of energy. And the very first month when I saw the reduction in the energy bill, it's like, boy, the money in the bank never made that kind of interest. So even though they quite often will talk to you about payback time, how long till it pays for itself? To me, that's not an issue. For me, the issue is, well, if I invested that money, what would be my return? And boy, this is really a good return.